हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुनील राजौरिया, केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, MIET मेरठ। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द स्टीम पाइपिंग। व्हाट इज स्टीम पाइपिंग? स्टीम पाइपिंग मीन्स हाउ टू इंस्टॉल द स्टीम पाइप्स इन केमिकल प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज। आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टीम पाइपिंग इन दिस लेक्चर। हियर The features, general layout and location of steam consuming equipment is of great importance in efficient distribution of the steam. Steam pipes should be laid by the shortest possible distance rather than to follow a building layout or road, etc. However, these may be come in the way of aesthetic design and architect's plan, and a compromise may be necessary while laying new pipes. Apart from proper sizing of pipelines, provision must be made for proper draining of condensate which is bound to form as steam travels along the pipe. For example, I will explain by taking one example. For example, a 100 mm well-legged pipe of 30 meter length carrying steam at 7 kg per centimeter square pressure can condense nearly 10 kg of water in the pipe in 1 hour unless it is removed from the pipe through traps. The pipes should run with a fall of not less than 12.5 mm in 3 meter in the direction of flow. There should also be large pockets in the pipes to enable water to collect, otherwise water will be carried out along the steam. These drain pockets should be provided at every 30 to 50 meters and at any low points in the pipe network. The pocket should be fitted with a trap to discharge the condensate. Necessary expansion loops are required to take care of the expansion of pipes when they get heated up. Automatic air vents should be fixed at the dead end of the steam mains, which will allow removal of air which will tend to accumulate. Now I will discuss about the steam pipe sizing and design. Any modification and alteration in the existing steam piping for supplying higher quality steam at exact pressure and quantity, there must be considered the following points. First one, pipe sizing. Proper sizing of steam pipelines help in minimizing pressure drop. As you already know about the pressure drop, the velocity for various types of steams are superheated 50 to 70 meter per second, saturated 30 to 40 meter per second, wet or exhaust 20 to 30 meter per second. The steam piping should be sized based on permissible velocity and the available pressure drop in the line. Next, the selecting a higher pipe size will reduce the pressure drop and thus the energy cost. However, the higher pipe size will increase the initial installation cost. By use of smaller pipe size, even though the installation cost can be reduced, the energy cost will increase due to higher pressure drop. It is to be noticed here that the pressure drop change will be inversely proportional to the fifth power of diameter change. Hence, care should be taken in selecting the optimum pipe size. One more thing is that the proper drainage and layout of the steam lines should be available. Here I will explain some guide for proper drainage and layout of steam lines. First one, the steam mains should be run with a falling slope of not less than that 125 mm for every 30 meters length in the direction of the steam flow. Drain points should be provided at intervals of 30 to 45 meters along the main line. Drain points should be should also be provided at low points in the mains and where the steam main rises. Ideal locations are the bottom of expansion joints and before reduction in stop valves. Drain points in the main lines should be through an equal T connection only. It is preferable to choose open bucket or TD traps on account of their resilience. Expansion loops are required to accommodate the expansion of steam lines while starting from cold. And last one, the point is to ensure dry steam in the process equipment and in branch lines, steam separators can be installed as required. Okay, thank you.